and the operation of these rides. This is for your safety. You do not expect to ride without wearing shoes.
Thank you. The line's shorter now. Yeah. Hopefully a bird will.
Everybody hands up.
I got on it.
Please be sure to
put up on the screen.
All right, come on.
Can I go to row one? Can you go to row two?
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
You don't want row one?
Gift shop. Once again, all bags, backpacks, and purses are not allowed. They must be left with a non-rider or a guest locker located with the Wavebreaker gift shop. If any of these items from the station, you will not be able to ride.
Go sit.
spot, you know?
Let's rock and roll.
Did it break down already? Is there a photo key?
There's you. That's the beginning when you were scared.
Look at Alice. Look at me.
Oh my god!
money. When you're taking video, take video like this.
Okay.
Here, hold on to my phone and my other GoPro battery, okay? Thank you. This is the line.
When riding
Catapult
Falls.
Yeah, line. Oh, this way.
2 and 48 inches must be accompanied by a supervisor.
No, I think that's the exit.
All riders,
I think it's this way.
Must be wearing shoes.
Is this the entrance? Oh, this is the entrance? Okay. That's confusing.
Right there. Oh, we're a little late, I suppose. Oh, my God. Did y'all all get wet?
There's so many other rides.
Can you?
Walker. Do not get scared, Lauren. If you have a bag, a backpack, or a purse, do not expect to ride.
Here, can I just get on?
got so many.
See, if you double five it, you can be happy to right there as a five.
Oh, no. Are you leaving?
dark gray in coloration. This is a camouflage that allows them to blend in with their mother's shadow. As a beluga whale ages, they turn a brighter shade of white, which allows them to blend in with the ice caps and ice floes of their sub-Arctic environments. You'll notice that beluga whales do not have a dorsal fin. Instead, they have a dorsal ridge. The lack of a fin gives them a low profile, enabling them to go undetected by predators and prey alike. The dorsal ridge is thick and has a top layer of skin over it, which allows them to push up under the ice to create breathing holes. Another distinguishing characteristic of the beluga whale is their large round forehead called a melon. The melon is an organ used in echolocation and can help them locate food and maneuver in murky waters. The melon can also change shape as the whales produce sounds. Speaking of sounds, beluga whales have a nickname. They are called the canaries of the sea, due to the wide range and variety of vocalizations that they can emit. Let's listen in as our beluga whales demonstrate a few of these sounds for all of you today. The blowhole, which is located directly on top of their head. Whales and birds. That was our incredible pod of beluga whales. Engaging our animals physically and mentally helps us provide them the best possible care. We are able to provide this world-class care through a variety of interactions or sessions. One of my favorite types of sessions focuses on relationship building. We can build unique bonds that can truly last a lifetime. Our trainers and animals will all give you a glimpse at just how special these relationships can be. Like ice, jello, back rub, belly rubs, and even giving them toys. I think we're gonna be asking Pearl a second time. And this time we're not gonna have Elizabeth tap. We're gonna see if Pearl can remember exactly where she should be jumping in our habitat. You did hear the bridge again. So that was an excellent job. That's exactly what we are looking for. We're gonna see if we can ask our other animal, Chrissy, to now try the same behavior. There are a variety of ways of of course, reinforce our animals, but there's also a variety of ways that we can reinforce them through sessions. We can use husbandry sessions, that behavior again. Now, we are well acquainted with our beluga whales, but we are also home to a second species here, our Pacific white-sided dolphins. The first distinguishing characteristic you might notice is their unique coloration. Unlike bottlenose dolphins, which are a solid gray from their head down to their tail, Pacific white-sided dolphins are a black, white, and gray. This is a camouflage called counter shading and can be found in many species of the ocean, including many fish species, including sharks, and even in killer whales. Pacific white-sided dolphins are well known for their speed and can reach top speeds of up to 20 miles per hour. They are able to reach these top speeds using a group of muscles called the peduncle, which are located directly behind the dorsal fin all the way down to the tail flukes. This muscle is so strong it can get them up and out of the water in a behavior we like to call walking on water. Like beluga whales have the nickname canaries of the sea, Pacific white-sided dolphins are extremely athletic and agile animals and can jump over 20 feet in the air. They are known as the acrobats of the sea. All of the animals you have seen here today are champions for their ocean counterparts, which face increasing threat to their lives and habitats. Trash, noise pollution, declining food supply, and habitat loss plague our oceans. Your visit today directly supports SeaWorld's conservation and rescue efforts. In fact, SeaWorld has been able to rescue over 40,000 animals. That kind of teamwork is worth celebrating. Now that you've had the opportunity to meet and learn about the amazing animals in our care, we invite you to enjoy in their wonder as we welcome back our powerful pod of Pacific white-sided dolphins.
Thank you. across. Do you see lights up at top?
Oh, that's so easy. That's false.
Let's see here. Hey, Claire, do you have a tongue?
Wait a second, buddy. Do you have a tongue? Whoa, I see it in there. Cool.
Yeah, sea lions do have a tongue. Here, you gotta let us know.
Okay, step on over here for me, just for a moment.
back out over there. Perfect. Okay, now, Aliana, listen up here. Quick second. When you meet a sea lion, you want to make sure that you never, ever, ever touch a sea lion here. Oh, boy. You got that. Don't touch him there. Don't touch him here. Or here. Or here. We're a joke. That's good. Okay, Aliana, now look this way. And everyone smile. There we go. Let's hear it for Aliana today, everyone. Clyde? Clyde? Oh, where are you, Clyde? Oh, hey, there you are, buddy. Get over here. We gotta quit messing around. Okay, Scout. Now I think it's time that we test your marine species knowledge. Sure, boss. Do sea lions have a tongue?
Oh, that's so easy. That's false.
Let's see here. Hey, Claire, do you have a tongue?
Wait a second, buddy. Do you have a tongue? Whoa, I see it in there. Cool.
Yeah, sea lions do have a tongue. And you guys can get a closer look at that sea lion tongue right over here on the screen. Sea lions swallow their food whole, and researchers believe that they have...
Please join me in honoring these men, women, and their families. We thank you for your service. And now before we begin today's presentation, we would like to share this information with you about killer whales.
And is essential to all life, both in the sea and on land. There's one animal that is the perfect ambassador to the ocean, and that is the Orsinus orca, or killer whale. In just a few minutes, you'll meet SeaWorld's killer whale. First though,
more than just a job, it truly is a way of life. We have all dedicated our professional and personal lives to the care of these amazing animals. It's a huge responsibility, but the ultimate privilege to be able to care for, teach, learn from, and build strong relationships with these five killer whales. We're proud of what we do, and we're excited to share everything we've learned through those relationships with all of you tonight and for many years to come. So ladies and gentlemen, we hope you enjoy Orca Encounter!
One interconnected ocean. was amazing! Hi everyone, I'm here at the main stage, and those were two members of our killer whale family, showing off their size, speed, power, and those moving together in unison. These synchronized behaviors help to strengthen their social bond and allow them to problem solve as a group. This is just one reason why they're known as the ocean's top predator. Their scientific name is Orcinus orca. Their common name is killer whale. And our five whales have personal names of their own. Our three females are Takara, Sakari, and Kamea. Our two males are Tuar, and joining us now, Kaiyuke. Kamea is our youngest whale at 10 years old. Takara is her mother and our oldest whale at 32 years old. Takara is also the matriarch of our pod, which means she's the leader. These whales trust us and take an active role in their own health and well-being. Through the use of positive reinforcement training techniques, we're able to teach them husbandry or healthcare behaviors. And joining us at the slide-outs now are trainers Ceci and Malin to help demonstrate some of those behaviors. Now, one of the first behaviors we teach is called the fluke present, in which the whales present their tail flukes to their trainers. In this position, we are able to observe their entire bodies, and we also have easy access to the shallow veins in the white undersides of their tail. Our veterinarians can collect blood from these veins at least once a month, and as you can see, they remain calm throughout the entire procedure. Throughout today's experience, you will see the trainers giving back rubs, tail massages, or even massaging their pectoral flippers. Killer whales have very sensitive skin, and this is just a great way for us to build our relationship with them. Collecting blood is just one of the ways we ensure the health of our animals. Another important diagnostic is how much each animal weighs. So we weigh them every week by asking them to slide their bodies out onto a killer whale size scale in one of the back adjacent pools. You may notice the part of Kaiyuke's body, from his dorsal fin all the way down to his tail flukes, is still in the water. This is the peduncle, and it contains very large and powerful muscles and can easily weigh hundreds of pounds. So in order to get an accurate weight, we ask them to lift their heads and tails out of the water, just like that. And that's how we know that Kaiyuke weighs 9,710 pounds. It's important to weigh all of our animals to ensure our younger whales are growing and growing. Whales like Kaiyuke are maintaining healthy weights. All of our husbandry behaviors help to ensure our animals are healthy and thriving.
And the care isn't just physical. Mental stimulation and play are vital, and we surprise and engage with our whales at every opportunity. Play is how killer whales teach their young to hunt. And for the adults, play is important too. It seems that they just enjoy having fun. Making time for play is an important part of life for killer whales and for us.
Observational learning and mimicry play a critical role in the life of a killer whale. From the moment they're born, they learn necessary life skills by watching and playing follow the leader with their mothers and other members of their pod. Here at SeaWorld, they play follow the leader with us by mimicking our movements. So let's go down to the glass with our new friend Sophia and play a quick game. So Sophia raised one hand high in the air and give Kaiyuke a big wave. Look at that. He's paying very close attention to you. Killer whales have excellent eyesight both above and below the surface of the water. Killer whales are also very curious animals, and we often see them spy hopping or leaping out of the water to get a better view of their surroundings. We're going to demonstrate that today with a behavior called a sighting bow. Now he gets off to the bottom of this 40-foot pool. Turn your attention to center. This is Kai Yuke. Let's go down to the glass on the other side and learn more about how killer whales communicate. Killer whales actually can communicate in a variety of ways. The use of vocalizations is just one of them. So Douglas is going to help us demonstrate one of those vocals tonight. That was beautiful! Did you know that scientists believe that when a killer whale leaps out of the water, that that's another way of communicating, to make their presence known? You see, when a killer whale leaps out of the water and crashes back down, that's called a breach. And that sound can be heard for miles around. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Kai Yuke. Oh no! Douglas! We had absolutely no idea that was going to happen. But thanks for being such a great sport. We have a SeaWorld towel for you. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give both our volunteers a round of applause. As you can see, killer whales can communicate by making. Killer whales are amazing athletes. They can eat over 100 pounds of food a day. And depending on where they live and time of the year, that break can vary. Unfortunately, things like overfishing.
Did y'all get wet?
Together, we've got this.
ladies and gentlemen, we hope that by being here, these animals have inspired you and deepened your appreciation for killer whales, just as they have for all of us. We will continue to learn from them, and we hope that you will too. Have a great night here. Thanks for being here at SeaWorld San Antonio. Goodbye.
Follow SeaWorld on Facebook and Instagram.
These behaviors are about our natural world, and we are excited to share their story with you today.
Killer whales are the ocean's top predator. They use cooperation and communication, not just size and strength, to take their place at the top of the ocean's food web. At the bottom are small animals, like krill. At the top, the apex predator, the killer whale. Killer whales are as big as a bus, faster than an
Oh no! Michael! We had no idea that was going to happen. We just happened to have a SeaWorld towel for you, for being such a great sport. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give both of our volunteers a round of applause. joining us today, these animals have inspired you, deepened your appreciation for killer whales, just as they have for all of us. We will continue to learn from them, and we hope that you...
For this past road to rehabilitation, started from malnourishment, dehydration, and several other medical hardships. In 2018, the National Marine Fisheries Service determined this blue cap to be deemed as non-releasable, and SeaWorld San Antonio was selected to be the home of this rescued and orphaned blue cap, now named Tyonic. Tyonic was originally born in a large watershed in Alaska, known as the Cook Inlet. There is a population of belugas that reside in this bay year-round, and they are known as the Cook Inlet beluga whale. While beluga whales as a species are thriving, this small population is listed as endangered, with just over 300 individuals remaining. Tyonic is an amazing ambassador for his endangered ocean counterparts. He is 6 years old and is now thriving. He is even participating in several ongoing research projects, one of which is the Social Development Study, which focuses on beluga communication and how they interact with one another. As with all of our animals at SeaWorld, we'll continue to share what we learned from Tyonic to help his ocean counterparts. We are honored to share his story, and by working together, we can help keep Cook Inlet belugas safe and healthy for years to come. Thank you. Now please enjoy this presentation of Ocean Discovery. Woo!
I haven't seen the shirt in forever.
Oh, we'll see about that.
Hey, who are they?
oceans.
They look like germ carriers.
I've never seen anyone like you before. Hello out there.
Well, whoever you are, welcome. Ahoy, mateys.
Do you want to play with us?
Figure it out my own way.
sorry to scream like that, but I've never talked to an octopus before.
Well, I've never talked to a fish before. I'm Leonard.
Hi. Hello. I'm Dorsal. Why were you screaming?
I'm lost. I'm supposed to go and give someone something, but I don't know how to get there.
Oh. Well, I'm lost too. I got separated from my best friends, and I don't know where they are.
Best friends? Wow. I've never had a friend before. That sounds like something that would be nice.
You've never had a friend? Oh. Well, I could be your friend, and we could go together.
You? Me? Friends? Whoa! Okay, Dorsal, where are you going?
Well, the old pirate shipwreck.
Hey, that's where I need to go too.
Oh, well, I think we just need to go this way.
Okay, you bestest friend, let's go.
He's a good friend now.
Wait a minute. Dorsal, you're who I'm supposed to give this to. The gold medal.
That's the last clue.
Leonard, why me?
Well, I was supposed to give this to someone brave and kind. And you, my newest and bestest friend, are certainly that.
Wow.
So we did it. We found all three medals.
We get the treasure. Each other. You know what, Dorsal? I think you're absolutely right. Who needs a silly medal?
Yeah, I wouldn't have it any other way than an adventure with my two best friends. And you too, Leonard.
Thank you.
that big boy. Sometime. What do you think? Oh, that's just a mirror. No, it's not.
Yeah. Can you see? You're supposed to stand up? No, don't stand on that.
Stand on this, though. Thank you. It's in 45.
We need a tag.
Something. I don't know what it is. But there's something. Do you have your ticket on your phone? Okay.
Oh.
Honey.
You're welcome.
you.
Hi there, guys.
Great.
Thank you.
Oh, they have maps? Honey, grab me a map. They haven't had maps in ever. I'm using my map from like back when they still had a log flume. Oh man, these kids are gonna beat me to Grover. I'm gonna cry. It's not open yet, so. No, that's weird.
That's Corey.
That's me.
Thank you. Your children, especially during an overview.